Funding for Peter Cater in Concert, Spirit of Chautauqua, was provided by the Colorado Council on the Arts and Humanities, a state agency. And IBM, working in Colorado, working for Colorado.
In anticipation of a night of music, people gather as they have for nearly 100 years to picnic in the park, talk with old friends, and share in the magic of a special tradition. A summer's evening beneath the Flatirons, the foot of the Rocky Mountains, at Boulder's historic Chautauqua.
Thank you. Thank you. I do a lot of shows all year round, and the one that I always think about the most is the Chautauqua show here at Boulder in the summer. So it's always exciting, and I always try to do something a little special one way or the other. Most of these songs I wrote here in Boulder, just up in the mountains here. A lot of them on Sugarloaf Mountain, as some of you may already know. And this is one of them. It's called Easy Like Spring. I see myself as always evolving and changing, and it seems to me that right now, musically, I'm at a place of beginnings and endings. My roots are classical, and I write music for anything from video stuff to Broadway stuff to myself. Or, my albums range from more jazz fusion type things through very mellow, acoustic, laid-back type things to standard Christmas songs. I think that what's going to happen with my future albums is a lot more integration going on and a lot more of expressing who I feel like I really am on a musical level. Thank you.
The performance of the Peter Cater Group is one of many diverse events held throughout the year at the Boulder Chautauqua. Now the oldest continually operated Chautauqua west of the Mississippi, the Boulder Chautauqua began as a cooperative venture between Texas educators, railroad officials, and Boulder mercantile interests. And it quickly became a magnet for the culture-hungry settlers of the small university town at the foothills of the Rocky Mountains. Although the word Chautauqua has long existed as the Seneca Indian name for a western New York lake, its meaning remains open to interpretation. But regardless of its derivation, it's a term that has come to be associated with one of the most widespread and influential cultural movements ever to develop in the United States. Conceived by the Reverend John Vincent and Lewis Miller, the New York Chautauqua Assembly was founded in 1874 as a means of training Sunday school teachers. Early curricula was a mixture of Bible study and lectures on history, science, art, geography, and ancient language. Soon, artistic programs and performances were added. Headliners at the New York Chautauqua read like a who's who of American culture. Inventors Henry Ford and Thomas Alva Edison, social reformer Jane Addams, author Mark Twain, composer George Gershwin, and at least nine U.S. presidents. The Chautauqua movement spread from its home in western New York State across the country. By the turn of the century, there were over 150 Chautauquas. By 1924, nearly 40 million Americans attended Chautauqua assemblies. Today, the diverse tradition of Chautauqua is maintained in Boulder and only a handful of other locations. In Boulder, a strong lecture series includes programs on current social, economic, and political events. Sacred music remains a part of the performance schedule. Other cultural presentations, as well as the area's natural beauty, attract a diversity of participants. The Texas-Colorado Chautauqua, as it was originally called, opened on the 4th of July, 1898, amid speeches, music, fireworks, and other festivities. Each Independence Day, these origins are recalled at a community gathering, featuring much of the same popular classical music played at the turn of the century, such as this patriotic march by one-time Chautauqua performer John Philip Sousa. The ritual is then brought to its customary and spectacular conclusion. At the heart of the Boulder Chautauqua program lives the historic auditorium. Much the same as it was when it was first built, its venerable wooden frame and stage continue to reverberate with a rich blend of our musical heritage and the new sounds of today. Like so many performers before him, pianist Peter Cater has his own special feelings about the hall.
Boulder is definitely where I got started musically, and at least in writing my own material. And to some degree, Chautauqua Auditorium was the first big concert that I ever did. I had done smaller concerts in a few churches around town. But the auditorium was definitely the first place where I tried to go for a larger audience. It was the first place that I played after my first album came out in '83. And so there's definitely a real strong sense of coming home. You know, you walk out on the stage and everything's all wooden, and you know, the hall sort of breathes, you know, with the cracks in the wood, and you know, it's a big old barn type feeling, and it's just really, it's very gratifying to walk out there and, you know, see the people stretched all the way back to the end of the hall there. It's a good feeling.
I wanted to have you to myself here for just a song. For those of you that haven't heard the song before, there's a place in the song where you can really feel the caffeine sort of kicking in, you know, and that's where it gets its name, Espresso. I don't know how familiar you all are with my records. I just happen to have one with me. It's my collection album, the 1983 to 1990. Usually you have to wait around 10 or 15 years to do a collection album, but when you do two or three records a year, you can do one sooner. So this is one or two pieces off of my first, I don't know, 9 or 10 records. It's an hour and 15 minutes of music, and I put it together myself. And it's got this little booklet here, you know, it's got all this stuff in there. Picture of me when I was 7, you know, at the piano. Got a picture of me when I lived in LA, when I was roller skating 8 hours a day. Picture of me with my kids. Picture of all the guys in the band. That's good. Picture of me when I was often mistaken for a transient. And it's like a little 12-page thing, you know. I often sort of joke around that, you know, at my funeral, you know, whenever that is, you know, 50, 60, 70 years from now, some people like to, you know, do something that was real personal to them at their funeral. Like, I knew a costume designer who died, and at his funeral he had samples of his creations, costume-wise, during the wake and stuff like that. So I was thinking that when I die, that everyone that I invite to the funeral should have to listen to all my records. It would be a week-long affair. So could you pass this around so you all could look at it? I'm serious. Yeah. This one's called Dance of the Shingle People. Now, I always get the feeling when I come here that it's always the same people every year, the same 1,200 people sort of come in here, and this is sort of like some kind of reunion or something. Is that true? I mean, like, have all you people been coming? So I have to ask this, how many people are like, this is their first time here? Really? Well, then I guess I'm wrong. I guess, okay, so now I know. I hope you guys have had a good time. We've had a great time. Hope to see you guys again. You know, maybe Port La France Cafe Monday morning. Yeah. We'll do a little thing here. I think you'll recognize this song, so.
Funding for Peter Cater in Concert, Spirit of Chautauqua, was provided by the Colorado Council on the Arts and Humanities, a state agency. And IBM, working in Colorado, working for Colorado.